In Unit 4, we looked at sparse matrix vector multiply, SpMV, SpMV, noting that this is one of the most important operations in all of computing. What we're going to look at today is how to implement this efficiently. So first, a quick recap on what SpMV is. We wish to multiply a matrix by a vector. If this matrix is dense, where every entry in the entire matrix is represented in the matrix data structure, GPUs can get excellent performance. But many interesting matrices are what we call sparse. Many, if not most, of the entries in these matrices are zero. So we prefer to represent only the non-zeros in this matrix, which gives us two advantages. One, less storage, since we don't have to represent a bunch of zeros. And two, less computation, since we're not doing a bunch of multiplications and additions of zeros. If you need a refresher on how to multiply a sparse matrix by a dense vector, please take a short trip back to Unit 4, because what we're going to talk about today is a strategy to build a more efficient SpMV. The broad question that we want to answer in thinking about how to map this problem efficiently is, what is the role of a thread? Let's look at this sparse matrix to answer this question. Here we're using X's to represent non-zeros and blanks to represent zeros. We will consider two alternatives. The first is that we will assign one thread per row of the sparse matrix. Here, a thread is responsible for computing one entry in the output vector. And we do this by taking the dot product of this row with this column. Second, we will assign one thread per element in the sparse matrix. For instance, this element here. Here, a thread is responsible for doing one multiplication, in this case, times its corresponding element in the input vector, what we call a partial product, and then cooperating with other threads, this thread for instance, in summing up the partial products. So, which is better? The answer is, it depends, and we'll look at how to do both of them.